Hello friends, welcome to Dr. Rajkumar's Learning App. Today we are going to see about the government's proposal to raise the women's marriage age. So what is the context? So the bill which aims to increase the age of marriage for women was sent for the parliamentary committee. So this bill aims to empower the women. So how and why this bill was brought by the government, we'll discuss detail in this video. So firstly, what was the reason to increase the marriage age of the woman? So the government has come up with different reasons, different needs to increase the age of the marriage of the woman. So the first reason was the issues related to marriage and related motherhood. So what are the issues which are related to the marriage? First is motherhood. So when a girl is married at an early stage, there are various issues related to the pregnancy. There are miscarriages. Also, there are female infanticide, even female foricide. So this was the one of the reason related to marriage for which the government is bringing the act. Secondly, the health of the girls. Many of the girls who marry at an early stage, they are malnourished. So they are facing the issues during the pregnancy, and this is leading to higher maternal mortality rate as well as infant mortality rate. If we compare the statistics regarding to maternal mortality rate, it is nearly more than 100, and infant mortality rate, it is nearly 28 per 1000 live births. The second reason is to make the women empowered. So how it will be? If the age of the girl for the marriage, it is increased by 3 years. So it will be beneficial to girls to complete their education. It can help to get the necessary skills for livelihood. They can become independent with respect to financial requirements. The third reason was to bring the equality. Now there was a debate that Constitution of India, it provides equality to all the citizens irrespective of the caste, sex, birth, etc. So according to Article 15, the Constitution provides the equality for every citizens. So to bring the equality in the society, the act is very much important. Fourthly, National Human Rights Commission has also suggested previously that the marriageable age for both male and female, or the boys and girls, should be same. Also, Supreme Court, in the case Independent Thought case, it has given the judgment that it has recommended government to make the marriageable age for boys and girls same. So if we see with respect to this, or the reasons or the background, here we can find that population was not the aim, population control was not the aim of bringing this act. Why? Because recently National Family Health Survey, it is showing that the fertility rate, it has come down to 2.0, which is less than replacement rate which India was targeting. So automatically the population is getting controlled. So this act doesn't aim to control the population. So this bill was framed under recommendations of a committee which was set up by Ministry of Women and Child Development under Jaya Jetley. So this committee, it had consulted many of the universities as well as NGOs. Nearly 16 universities were consulted regarding the increase in the marriageable age of the woman or the girls. Secondly, it has recommended to increase the age to 21 years. So not only this, the committee has recommended to provide the access to these girls to the schools and colleges so that they can be empowered. And also to go to schools and colleges, it has recommended to provide the transportation facilities for the girls. Now, what is the problem with the transportation facilities? Many of the rural areas or the remote areas, they don't have accessibility. So the girls are unable to travel safely to the schools at a longer distance. So providing safe transportation is one of the most important aspect of the committee. Now, the committee has also recommended to develop the skills of the girls as well as to provide them business training. So why this is needed? So why skill development and business training is needed? So the women or the girls, they can become financially independent. And then lastly, it has also recommended to give the sex education in the schools and different educational institutes. Now, which are the different acts to be amended here? The first is Hindu Marriage Act of 1957, which has kept the age of the girls and boys at 18 and 21 years. The same is with respect to Child Marriage Restraint Act 1929, which is also called as Sarda Act. It has also raised the age for girls and boys for the marriage at 18 and 21 years after the amendment of 1978. And the Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006, it also gives the same marriageable age for both boys and girls. Now this bill of 2021, it will seek to amend the other personal laws as well, like Hindus, Christians, Muslims and Parsis, as well as it will amend Special Marriage Act of 1954. So this act will bring the amendments in this of the acts to change the marriageable age for the girls from 18 to 21 years. Now, what are the advantages of this act? The first is gender equality. The act brings to give gender equality to both boys and girls, which is already it was provided by the Constitution of India according to Article 15. Secondly, there are many demographic benefits of the act. First is it will help to maintain the sex ratio. Second is it will provide the opportunities for girls for their personal development, like education, skill development, employment opportunities, etc. So the girls will be able to complete their education, as well as it will help to empower the women. It will help women to think independently, to take the rational decisions if the age is increased to 21. And lastly, even though it was not aimed at, but it will also help to control the population of India. Thirdly, there are health benefits. Just it was said previously that the reasons for the maternal mortality rate as well as infant mortality rate, the reason is malnutrition, and it was impacting the health of the girls as well. So by increasing the age, women can become healthy. So it will help to reduce the infant mortality rate as well as maternal mortality rate. Fourthly, it will help in the responsible parenthood. So the girl who is near about 22 years of age will be able to take the rational decisions regarding to the pregnancy or the motherhood. So both boys and girls, they can think rationally regarding to their parenthood. They can be in a situation to decide whether they have to become the parents or not. And lastly, it will change the social perception. It will change the social perception about the women or the girls. So these are certain advantages of the bill. But there is the other side of the bill as well. There are certain disadvantages of the bill. So is the malnutrition major issue for the girls who are married? Is there any other issue which is responsible for the malnutrition? Yes, there is. It is the poverty. So why girls are actually married at an early stage? Because initially the parents of the girls, they are initially poor. They are living in the poverty. So they want to get rid of the girl, so to reduce their burden. And because of this poverty, the girls are malnourished. So it's not the reason because of the marriage that the girls are malnourished. But the root cause for this malnourishment, it is the poverty. Secondly, the girls who are completed 18 years of age, they have the voting right. It means that they are having the right to choose the representatives in the parliament. But according to this act, they will not be able to choose their partner or their husband. So this is one of the major issue. Thirdly, it is very difficult to implement. So why? Because already we have the act, Child Prohibition Act, which prohibits the child marriage or the marriage of the boys and girls below the 18 years of the age. Even though there are nearly 23% of the child marriages all over the world taking place only in India. If we look at the statistics, there are nearly 56% of the women in the age 20 to 24 who say that they got married before the age of 18 years. So right now we are facing the difficulty to stop the marriage before 18 years. So will this act help to stop the marriage before 21 years? So here is the problem. Again, this act goes against Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, which says that a citizen has a right to marry, has a right to choose her partner or his partner. So again, this bill goes against the Article 21. So these are certain disadvantages with respect to the bill. So what are the suggestions with respect to bill, with respect to stop or curtail the child marriage in India? The first is education. Providing education is one of the most important aspect to reduce the child marriage in India. If we see from recent statistics that the marriageable age for girls, recently it has increased to 22.1 years. It means that those girls who are getting the better education, they are marrying after 21 or 22 years of age. So if you give education to these girls, automatically the age for their marriage will increase. Secondly, we have to give political empowerment. We have to make women politically empowered. So we have provided women's reservation in the Panchayat Raj institutions according to the Constitution of India. But we have failed to provide them reservation in Parliament. So if this bill talks about the welfare of the women, let the women take the decision regarding to their welfare. So for this, the women need to be empowered politically. So regarding to the policy making, regarding to the decision making at the national level, the representation of the women in the parliament is very much important. So we can provide them the reservation into the parliament, which will help to take the decisions regarding to their own welfare. And lastly, we can provide them skill development. So why skill development is needed? So that they can become independent financially. So they don't have to depend on their husband or the partner for the financial purpose or the financial requirements. So these are certain suggestions regarding to the bill. Now the bill, it is a much needed step for the empowerment of the women or the girls. But there are again certain areas, gray areas, which we have to focus on. So thanks for joining us. Thank you.